Hi there, Doug Stuman with IT Creations. And today, and every day after, given this video will be posted to the internet, we have the 2U Gigabyte S252-ZC0 server. This is a storage server with a side-mounted storage configuration that can support up to 24 3.5-inch storage bays in a 2U chassis with 12 bays on each side. It's like a magic act. The drive cages are only accessible when you pull the server out of the enclosure. This one also supports dual third-generation AMD EPYC CPUs. Let's take a look. With support from AMD's third-generation 7003 series EPYC Milan processors, this system can provide up to 64 cores per socket for up to 128 physical cores and 256 virtual threads. As a storage server, it is designed for software-defined storage, big data, used as a backup server for streaming multimedia content, and a host of other applications that require fast read-write speeds and offer scalability. I must say I do like the simplicity of the naming convention, but the constant revisions are starting to bring me down a little bit. That said, only one revision on this one so far. That S on the S252-ZC0 server also means this system is a storage server. Elegantly simple. The front of the chassis is rather nondescript, and you might mistake this system for use with some other application rather than the storage, as none of the storage is even visible on the front of the chassis. To accommodate the storage, the chassis is also quite deep at 880 millimeters or 88 centimeters. Consider an edge server is at the other extreme with a chassis depth of 500 millimeters or less. Before we see the side storage situation, let's check out the front of the system. Right in the center of the chassis, there is an ID button, reset button, and power on button. Just below that, HDD status and system status LEDs, plus two USB 3.0 ports for a crash cart. And moving around to the other side, there are panels on both sides of the system that cover 12 3.5-inch drive cages for 24 bays total. Are you interested in the Gigabyte S252-ZC0 server? For a limited time, you can save up to $500 off this system listed on our site, or one that you can configure to your specifications using our handy-dandy configurator. The configurator will track your choices for CPU, memory, storage, and add-on cards, and adjust the price accordingly so you don't have to wonder about cost. Just click that link for more information, and when you're ready to make a purchase, just mention this video. Simple. The 12 3.5-inch storage bays placed on either side of the chassis support SATA or SAS, hot swappable SSDs and HDDs. There is an onboard 12 gigabit per second SAS expander board, but you will need a SAS controller add-on card if you want to install SAS drives on the system, not to mention if you want access to all 24 drive bays. As expected, drive trays are toolless for ease of installation, but more importantly, removal and reinstall if for some reason you need to replace a drive or two. Total raw capacity on this system is listed at up to 400 terabytes of storage using SAS or SATA. Various open source software-defined storage system utilities have been validated by Gigabyte to simplify the deployment process. Moving around to the back of the system, there is an additional 2.5-inch two-bay drive cage capable of supporting SAS, SATA, or Gen 4 NVMe drive types. That unit can also be used to support the OS in a mirrored RAID for redundancy or for additional fast storage if you go with the NVMe option. Redundant 80-plus platinum 1300-watt PSUs are right beside the drive cage, with three PCI slots to either side and an I.O. panel in the middle at the bottom portion of the chassis. The I.O. panel has a system status LED, power button with LED, and ID button with LED. After those, a management LAN port, legacy VGA port, and two USB 3.0 ports. There are no integrated LAN ports on this system for network connectivity, but there are six PCI Gen 4 low-profile slots hidden behind those cover plates with three to either side. That dedicated RJ45 management LAN port provides access to the integrated ASSPEED AST2500 baseboard management controller, and in turn, Gigabyte's management console. The Gigabyte management console comes preloaded on the system and is free of charge. The Gigabyte management console is sufficient for a single server or a small cluster. It offers a browser-based graphical user interface and can perform real-time health monitoring and management, plus support for standard IPMI specifications, automatic event recording, and control of MegaRAID adapters for SAS, SATA, and NVMe. The Gigabyte Server Management, or GSM, is also free of charge but takes management a step further with added features. Through the GSM agent, it leverages the Gigabyte Management Console in each server and can be used to control clusters of servers over the internet. It has a few sub-programs which enable more functionality like GSM Server, GSM Command Line Interface, GSM Agent, GSM Mobile, and a GSM plugin for use with VMware vCenter. Moving on. Removing the middle cover and the rear cover panel, you can see this platform does not have the standard server layout. True, all the storage is at the front of the chassis, but storage occupies more than half the chassis length, with CPUs, memory, and PCI slots all squeezed in at the back of the chassis. The PSUs are all in a tilt-up cage, and just beneath that are the CPU sockets, two of them, to either side of the CPU sockets, four memory module slots for 16 total, and then a bank of three PCI 4.0 slots to either side of the chassis. Just behind the storage cages, six fans pull fresh air in through the case. The fans feature automatic fan speed control and use sensors throughout the case to ensure the best cooling and power efficiency. AMD's third generation EPYC processors provide the compute, support for DDR4 memory, 8-channel memory architecture, plus PCIe Gen 4 offering twice the bandwidth of PCIe 3.0. With a thermal design power range of up to 200 watts, this system can support CPUs with up to 64 physical cores and 128 virtual threads each for up to 128 physical cores and 256 virtual threads if needed. With 8-channel memory architecture and only 16 memory module slots total, each memory module gets its very own memory channel, exploiting memory speeds of up to 3200 megahertz. Registered, load reduced, and 3DS RDIMMs and LRDIMMs are supported. At capacity, using 256 gigabyte modules in all slots, this system will max out at 4 terabytes of memory. With those six PCI slots, you can install additional RAID controllers, host bus adapters, and high-speed network interface controllers. Each of the low-profile PCIe 4.0 slots offers a x16 slot length coupled with a x16 PCI bus connection for maximum bandwidth. And if you want to install some high-performance network controllers or HBA adapters, these slots will provide full bandwidth for your data to move about the network. And there you have it, the Gigabyte S252-ZC0 storage server offering dual AMD EPYC 7003 series CPUs, up to 4 terabytes of memory, and 24 3.5-inch storage bays for up to 400 terabytes of raw storage, all in only 2U. As a storage platform with a number of options for both RAID, HBAs, plus optional high-speed network connections, it can be configured a number of ways to support your business needs. It's at IT Creations now, along with a bunch of other servers, GPU servers, and high-performance workstations. If you're looking for IT hardware, then click one of those links below or one of them right there, and check out itcreations.com. We have what you're looking for. Maybe you don't even know you need it yet, but we have that too. Until next time, I'm Doug Stuman with IT Creations, and thanks for watching.